Now to our Commitment 2012 coverage tonight. Two new polls released today show Angus King's lead slipping in Maine's U.S. Senate race. The former governor is still leading the pack, but the contest is now tightening. News8's Paul Merrill joins us live with the latest. Paul?
Well, Tracy, these are the first public polling numbers we've seen since June, and they show that the race to replace Olympia Snow may not end up being as much of a runaway as many people thought.
It means everything. Now let's go win this election.
All smiles in Angus King's Portland headquarters, but two new polls released today show that the independent former governor's lead may be slipping away. A few months ago, King was polling above 50%, but a new Maine People's Resource Center poll now puts King in the low 40s. Summers remains in the high 20s, while Dill heads into double digits at almost 15%. New public policy polling numbers are similar, except they put Summers at 35%, just 8 percentage points behind King.
It's nice to be ahead. It's tightening, and that's what $1.7 million of negative advertising will buy you.
King says his campaign will strike back in a positive way against the negative ads being bought with out-of-state money.
Because I can tell you one thing, the people that are paying for it don't give a damn about Maine. They don't know Portland from Presque Isle. They're not involved in our issues. They don't care about Maine at all. This is all about power in Washington, and they're scared of Maine.
While King blames the ads, his competitors say the numbers are changing because of the work they've done introducing themselves to voters.
Trying to shake every single hand and see every single person and let them know, you know, that again, my concerns are their concerns.
We haven't spent any money on television advertising, and our numbers have doubled because we've been out talking to Maine voters about what they care about.
Pollsters say the Summers numbers may vary between the polls because one included the non-King third-party candidates and the other didn't. Both polls also show President Obama with a double-digit lead over Mitt Romney here in Maine. Live in the studio, Paul Merrill, News 8.